we have been experiencing where a situation whereby some clients are saying, no, me, the architect of my incubator is raw or what? First thing first, how do you determine the architect of your eggs? You have to make sure all the eggs in your incubator are fertilized. So how do you know that the all eggs in your incubator are fertilized? After incubation of the eggs in an incubator, that's why there's an instruction here. Come closer, we show the people. On the instructions here, there's we clean and disinfect the incubator. Then plug incubator to power source. Always add warm water, which is love for about 35 to 37 degrees. But we emphasize, in case you cannot manage, in case you don't have your thermometer, it's better you just put the tap water or the water to the room temperature. Then obtain well-preserved fertile eggs. Eggs can be fertile, but if they are not well-preserved, they'll be spoiled. Or they will start developing, but they'll fail to continue because they wasn't well-preserved. Then warm fertile eggs to room temperature before putting them in an incubator. Then some people keep their eggs for incubation in the fridge. We don't allow that. Eggs for incubation, they have to be kept at a certain degree or at a certain temperature, which is a standard temperature, which is about 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. That's an acceptable standard. Then the standard in room temperature is 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. So you make sure your eggs are to that degree. And the other word of caution, eggs when they are kept in a room above 35 degrees Celsius, some even at 33 degrees and above, some they start getting activated, the enzymes start getting activated, hence the development starts inside the machine, inside the egg. So the time you put the egg in the incubator, you find that you put it, maybe you incubate it for some few days, you start seeing even blood forming, not knowing that where it was being kept earlier on, it was developing, but it was developing in a rough condition. Whereby in the daytime it develops a bit like in this hot weather or hot season we are in, they might even continue developing even at night. Some will develop a bit during daytime, at night it stops. Some which are strong enough, which are, if the egg or the parent is having good immunity and the chicks is, it's laid well as the chicks are also well fed and the cocks was well fed, the egg might survive even in some harsh conditions. But you find that by the time you're putting it in the incubator now, it's now the time it has even lost now the strength. You put it in the incubator, the egg dies. That's where you see some, like maybe just a dark spot inside the egg. Then the other thing is mark on both sides of the egg. Why do you mark on the other side, you mark the date. When you are putting the egg on an incubator, on the other side, you mark the date when the egg has to be out of an incubator. So, like over the same thing, marking of the eggs, that's why you see on our incubator here, we have the eggs are marked. So, we've marked the date when the egg will be out of the incubator. You make sure you light collect date. So, usually we add 2 extra days. Instead of 21 days, we add some 2 more extra days because there are some eggs which takes longer to hatch. So back to where I was. Then put on, then I got to point number 11, number 11, turn eggs at least 4 times a day. Applicable only for manual turning incubators. Then point number 12, candle eggs on 10th day and only leave eggs with development inside in an incubator. So now this is the point where now I want to tell you most about. So here on candling, that's when you know the eggs, that's where you even get your hatchlate. That's how you count now the hatchlate or the hatchability of your eggs, one, or the hatchlate of an incubator. So on this candling, that's where now I want to show you something about candling. So I have my phone here, it has got a very good touch. So I'll get one egg, I'll get some eggs at random. So you can see, have you seen this egg here? Is the light going? Are you able to see the light? Yeah. It's clear and it's clear up to this date. This is the number, it's supposed to arch on day number 8. The egg doesn't have to look this clear. So, this is showing the egg started developing at some point because of the hotness, but it didn't continue. So, these eggs are only remaining with 8 days. So, it has to be like much developed. Have you seen this one? So, this one is okay. This one is going to arch. Have you seen? It's much dark, the arch is already big, the feathers are started growing on the side. You have seen this one? This one is totally clear. This one, there's no much of the life in here. So that's where now preserving is coming in. These eggs are seeming, there was fertilized, but they wasn't well preserved before they were put in an incubator. So have you seen this one? This one was not even fertilized. So you can see all these eggs was put on the same date. So these are showing, yes, the dark, the blood is, lines are very thick inside and they're almost turning black. Now those which are just showing like a small development, then it stops like this one. It's showing just a dark spot on the side. So it means that this one, it's somehow it started developing, but it felt white, was not well preserved. This one is okay. This one is going to watch. Then the other things on this same incubator here, we've put 2 trays. So I'm having much of the problems with the people with the portable small incubators. But for us, we have not been having problems with this small incubators because we have been hatching our eggs using these same small incubators and also the bigger incubators. So always they have to be water here. You don't let this water dry, please. You kill your chicks inside the eggs. You make sure they are both bulbs working for eating inside the machine. From there, this machine has to be plugged to power always. So like in our case now, we don't have power. So what are we using? We have our backup here, our small inverter here, and our small battery here. So that we are always connected to power. So usually when we know these days we'll be experiencing power cuts, and it's important you get your schedule from the Zesco, like they tell you in case there will be a power cut and so like, but those, they're also unforeseen situations whereby even Zesco themselves, they don't know, they just realize a transformer has busted. So you make sure you have your backup. So we also have a genset here. It's a backup which we use for the bigger machines. Because sometimes we fill up the archer and the incubator, a big one. So when it's filled up, this small package cannot manage. So we connect it to the generator. But nevertheless, you can buy bigger inverters, bigger batteries, the standard ones, so that you can be using much cheaper energy. So thank you for watching. I hope you have learned something. And please, let's try to do our part and reduce on complaining, because complaining won't take us anywhere. Thank you for watching. God bless you.